Good morning, children. Well, to begin the class today, why don't you all look around and see what you all can see in this classroom as of now. Now, you have the chairs here, the tables, your bulletin boards, the fan, light, the green board here, you yourself, I'm here, chalk, your books, bags. Now, what are these things? Well, these things are matter. And today we are going to be studying at length about what matter is. So if I say these things are matter, but actually what is matter? Now you're going to say, ma'am, this water bottle is matter. But what is matter? What is this bottle actually made up of? Now everything, including you and me, we are all made up of matter. We have very small, minute particles which are known as molecules. So we are actually made up of molecules. Molecules can be further divided into atoms, but as of now we are going to be talking about what molecules are. So matter is made up of molecules. These are the building blocks of matter. Okay, so matter, as you all are seeing here, for example the duster, and for example the water bottle here and the water inside, everything is matter. You are sitting on the chair. The chair is matter. You yourself are matter. So what qualifies to be matter? Matter is anything which has mass, that is weight, and is occupying space. Now for example, I'm standing here, I'm occupying space here. You sitting on your chairs, you are occupying the space on the chair. So you are qualified. Obviously you all have weight. The water bottle here has weight. I've kept it on the table. It has occupied space here. It has weight. So this is matter. So what is matter? Matter is anything that has mass and occupies space. Now matter can be classified into three forms, that is solid, liquid and gas. Now why are we saying that certain matter, as we see around, is classified under three broad categories? That is because here, now we go back to the building blocks of matter, that is the molecules. Now it is the arrangement of this particular molecule here that will define, that will tell which state, in which state the matter is going to fall. For example, the molecules in a solid are very closely packed. They are tightly packed, and because of the closeness in which they are packed is giving the rigidity, the firmness to a solid. So you can't very easily change the shape of a solid until and unless you apply force. So your table here is solid. You cannot change the shape of solid, this table here, until and unless you actually break it with an axe. Yes, of course you can. If you say, ma'am, we can change the shape. Yes, of course you can, until and unless you apply force. Without applying force, you cannot change the shape of this table. You cannot change the shape of the duster. They are rigid. Why? Because of the arrangement of molecules here. So, we can say the solids have a fixed shape. And the molecules here are very closely packed. Very importantly, we know that they cannot flow, right? Now, if we come to the next state of matter, which is the liquid, obviously you all can see by yourself that we all have seen liquids in our life. Now, example of liquid is water, milk, oil, to name a few. Now, they are like very different from the state of matter, solid. Why? Because here again, we come back to molecules, the arrangement of molecules. Here, the molecules have a little space between them, and that is giving the liquid, that is why it is giving the liquid its property to flow. So we can say here that a liquid has fixed volume. But it does not have a fixed shape. A liquid, because it has a tendency to flow, it takes the shape of the container in which it is poured. Now this bottle here, if I pour it in a glass, it will take the shape of the glass. So a liquid takes the shape of the container in which it is poured. So we can say that the liquid has no fixed shape. And obviously a liquid flows from a higher level to a lower level. Now if we come to the third state of matter, which is the gaseous form of matter, we can say that the molecules here have a lot of space between them, and that is the reason why that the gas, the gaseous form of matter, does not have any fixed volume, nor does it have any fixed shape, and the gas flows in all directions. Diagrammatically, if we show, for example, if you're going to take this to be the solid, the molecule, we're going to be talking about the arrangement of the molecules here. Now, as you all can see, the molecules in a solid are extremely tightly packed. And they have very little or no space between them. Or we can say the intermolecular space in a solid is absolutely zero or very less. What is intermolecular space? Space between two molecules is known as intermolecular space. So, in the molecule of a solid, the space between two molecules is very less. And that is why they are packed closely. Now, if we come to a liquid, intermolecular space, as you all can see, you have space between the molecules here, and in a gaseous form, they are free flowing. Now, another term to remember is, we did intermolecular space, space between two molecules. Now, we are going to be talking about the intermolecular force. What is the intermolecular force here? The force of attraction between two molecules. So which is the maximum in solid, and that is why it's keeping the two molecules of solid tightly close to each other. In a liquid, the molecular force is less and it is the least in gases. Now we know the three states of matter, the solid, liquid and gas. Now, Children, the three states of matter are not rigid. You can change the shape, the states of matter from one state to the other. Now, how are we going to achieve that? Now, for example, let's try a very simple experiment. If you go home, take a few blocks of ice, put them in a bowl and leave it out for some time. When you come back, you will see that you cannot see ice anymore. Now, what is ice? Ice is a solid form of matter, water, solidified water is ice. Now, you've kept this ice out in the open, and after some time when you come and see, there's water instead. Now, this ice has changed to water. Now, this is no magic. There's a reason behind why ice has changed to water. Ice was kept in the freezer, which has very low temperature. You took the ice out and kept it in room temperature, which was comparatively much warmer compared to the refrigerator freezer. Now, because of the warmth, because of the heat applied, the ice changed to water, and this process is known as melting. Now, what if I want the ice back? How do I get the ice back? We do a reverse here. What do? We take the water, we put it back in the freezer, and you see that after a few hours, you'll see that you've got your ice back. Now, this process is known as freezing.